What happens is generally people come in late, so we start about, you know, 4 or 5 around that time.
Oh,
All right, so we'll probably wait for a few minutes. I will then kick start it, say around 4:30 in the next 5 seconds. Yeah,
are we live now, or it's only between you and I that is happening currently?
it is only between, I think it is going to go live in, going, it's live now,
Okay.
but that's fine. I mean, we can just put up our videos and wait. So I'll be sharing my screen, and you know, the questions when they appear, I'll ask them accordingly. So
So you're taking questions as on the go, or you're going to take questions at the end? In the sense, the
the Q&A
audience.
with the audience will be at the end.
All right.
Let me know once you can see my screen.
Yes, I can.
Can see the presentation, right?
Yes.
Okay, great. So first we will you know, speak here first, let the audience see everybody, and then
let me know whenever you want to go live. Okay, I'm just.
I will. I mean, I'll say it out loud, and we can go live now. So we can start. All right. Two minutes more and we'll start.
Awesome. You're in office. You guys are back to office.
Yeah, actually, we've started work since the last 2 months.
Wow, very brave.
No, actually, some of us stay nearby, no? So we come. And most of us who are coming are vaccinated, at least both the doses are done.
Yeah, vaccination only helps you not to die.
That is true. In fact, I have not been able to get my second dose till now because of some complication in the
Even
first dose
worse.
itself.
That's even worse. You should be very careful.
But I've had COVID almost twice, so I'm kind of.
That worries me. You should be
Oh.
very reckless. You should not be reckless at all. It's something that you should be careful about.
Yeah, I'll take that. I think we'll start because we have a lot of questions to go through.
Okay.
Okay, so of course, attendees can keep joining. So, thank you everyone for joining in. I'm very happy to, you know, being hosting this webinar today, and I'm, you know, very grateful for the speaker that I have today with me because we are going to learn a lot from him, right? Before we start and dive in, the first things first, let's you know, get you through the drill. So it's going to be a 35-minute session. The topic is something that can be spoken about for length, but we don't have that much time, so we'll try to cover as much as possible. If you have questions, please start posting them in the chat box and we will respond to them at the end of the session. If for some reason you are logged out or not able to hear or see us, please try logging in again. Hopefully that solves the problem. Okay, and we will go right into the presentation. So the topic for today is the evolution of media. And to discuss that, today I have with me Mr. Ram Mohan Sundaram. He was a country head and managing partner at DDB Mudra Group. And I would like Ram basically introduce himself and tell us a few words about DDB Mudra Group.
Okay, so I head the media business for the group. You rightly said I am the country head and managing partner for integrated media, which includes digital, television, print, and of course radio. So we've got over 100 odd clients and our billings are over $300 million in India. And we're part of the Omnicom network globally. Okay. So that's what I do.
All right. Thank you so much, Ram. And you all know me mostly. I am your host, Meldon Moraes. I handle marketing and partnership with Connect Insights. We are a social listening and customer experience platform that enables almost 300 brands to keep their customers happier. And I would like to just say this, that DDB Mudra is also one of our customers that we work with very closely. And I'm happy to have Ram today with us. All right, so we'll start right in. We have a set of questions that I will be asking Ram. These are the questions that I've come across from people whom we interacted with and told them, okay, we're having this webinar, so what kind of questions you'll come across? And we have a set of questions that they have shared, and we'll be taking them one by one. And of course, we'll be answering the audience question also towards the end. All right, so Ram, let's dive right in, and let's start with the first question, because that's the topic that we're going to discuss today. So in a nutshell, as per your experience, working with so many brands and in the industry, how has media evolved over the past few years?
See, the evolution of media in India has a funny track. Now, okay, Let's go back in time. If you look at how media evolved in matured markets where the size of media is, mm-hmm, for example, the kind of spends that happen, if you have to compare the US to India, India is minuscule, right? I mean, Google's revenues are over 100 billion. I'm saying the digital revenues are close to $100 billion, whereas in India, the overall media landscape is not more than 10 billion. So that's just one aspect to it. And when you look at the entire media story in the US, it exceeds over $300 billion. So that's how large a market like US is, but the evolution in the US was very, very different. I mean, mm-hmm, if you look at the first medium for distribution of news or information or any communication was the print medium, right? So that's right. Something that remained common across most countries in the world. Mm-hmm. But post that, radio happened, and radio in the US became big because of HBO, who started charging people, started charging advertisers for the first time on radio through a boxing match, which happened with Muhammad Ali and stuff like that. Mm. And that became huge. Now, when did radio evolve in India? I mean, while we had the All India Radio since forever, private FM channels started, I think, early 2000s or little mid 2000s. That's when it actually started growing, right? And so, So in 1950s is when radio grew in the US, whereas in 2005 is when the Indian market was matured enough for advertisers to start advertising locally. Okay. So look at the gap. There's like, we're talking of 60 odd years in between. Yes. And that's a lot of time, right? But the funny aspect is that in the US, cable was as early as in the 70s. Mm-hmm. And India, we've had Doordarshan, I think, till 1993. Mm. Only then, once the economy opened up, once there were a lot more brands in the country, once the GDP started growing, automatically advertising spends grows because you have a lot more brands. It was not because the economy opened up in 1991. So you started seeing a lot of wires getting pulled all over the place, and you knew that, I think the first ever sports event was, I think, India toured Australia, and you were all very zapped to see the kind of production value that came in way back in 1993. Now, if you go back in time and look at those edits of how it was vis-a-vis what it is now, it's astounding, right? I mean, now we've got 4K cameras, and those days it was pretty hard to even follow the ball, leave alone sneakometers or any of the other advanced technology that is used by the third umpire today. So the evolution has been weird. So while we know that 1993 is when the first time cables got pulled in, it was in the early 60s that cable television came up, right? Okay. Now, was that then you had the dish evolution, right? That mm-hmm. happened in the US as early as 80s, and it happened in India 2007. So around that time. Now, that has also become redundant, right? Because, you know, most of the times when it rains in Bombay, if you're in Bombay, you probably, and if you have a dish connection at home, half the time you would not be able to see any broadcast because it's mm-hmm. raining so heavily, right? We passed through that, and then cut 2021, you got streaming services. And that happened because of Jio's evolution in 2016. Now, streaming in the US started about 15, 17, 18 years ago. So it is any evolution is directly linked to the kind of infrastructure that is there, the kind of GDP of a country, because, you know, when there is consumption, automatically there is enough and more legroom for people to spend money, and when consumer spends money, automatically brands want to attract them. So it's a different scenario. Now, a whole host of, to the long story short, the whole story of evolution has been topsy-turvy in India, okay, unlike several other parts of the world. So if you look at the current generation, I mean, when I say current generation, I'm not too old, but if you look at a lot many people who are consuming the kind of communications which is getting distributed on the phone or connected TV, is very different to what it would ideally been before 2016, right? I had about four different Tata Sky connections at home. Mm-hmm. There's nothing that exists today. Everything is streamed, right? And that's because you have phenomenal capabilities of streaming that is bringing that kind of data straight into your home, and it's seamless. Now, that current, when I say current generation, people who are in their 18s to, let's say, 24, 25, actually skipped the entire communication that used to happen on television, and they're right, consuming it on a different device, right?
Absolutely.
They probably would have skipped the laptop evolution as well, except while they're working, whereas I remember logging on to YouTube through my laptop because that's the, and when you're in office, because that's the best place you probably get that kind of speeds. And so that I'm saying, as early as even 2010, I don't remember watching, to 2008, I don't even remember watching YouTube at home.
Okay.
Right. It used to always be at office. So, and that's why, you know, but targeting capabilities were also skewed at one point in time in early 2008, 2009, 10 to 12 was actually peak time for targeting people, because that's where most consumption used to happen.
Yeah.
So that's how the evolution has been. And now today, that generation, which, and India is the youngest population in the world, you know, naturally majority of the population consumes everything on a handheld device.
Absolutely.
But the fundamentals of streaming originates from television.
You know? Okay.
All so right. The device change has happened, but the content consumption is still video. So
I agree to that.
So in short, that's how the evolution has been. It's been pretty funny.
Thank you, Ram, for taking us through this journey. You know, in fact, I have grandparents who are almost like 90 plus years old, and they have basically told me stories about how they were longing for a TV. They've seen TV, and today they are consuming data on, I mean, basically seeing videos on, you know, mobile phones, YouTube and all of that stuff, even Netflix and all for that matter. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. how they have even, you know, been able to adapt to this, you know, evolution has been really phenomenal. And it's good that you've given us this picture on the journey of how media has, you know, brought us here. So moving on to the next, like you mentioned about television and how television has been the basic of everything. But in given today's landscape, like the current landscape that we have, how important is traditional media in this evolving media landscape? How relevant it is today?
So print is dying. It's evident, right? But when I say print is dying, it's the classifieds aspect of that business which got killed very early on, and now it's completely dead. Okay. But you'll be surprised how bounce back typically happens. If anybody pulled out a Times of India in Bombay, there were five jackets the other day. Right. Mm-hmm. So it also, and the distribution strength continues to be the way it is. So there are certain categories which work very well, right, on print, right? And the growth of print is not reduced. While there are 15,000 different magazines and newspapers that exist in India, every survey tells us that there's, I mean, it's not been very large, but print is growing at 4-5%, even when categories are within print, like classifieds, for example, is dying. But it is, you know, if you need to make the right kind of impact, you really typically can't miss, let's say, in the Sun Times and Times of India and a Hindu.
Absolutely.
In India, right? Mm-hmm. So that's the way it is. In terms of television, there's massive growth, right? Like I said, the consumption is different. It could be through connected TVs or it could be through streaming.
Right.
But every number that exists in research currently tells that, see, look at how many homes are connected in India, right? On cable, I think about 300, 350 million. So the opportunity to connect is a billion plus.
Right.
So that growth trajectory is happening. A lot more TVs are getting sold, but the kind of TVs that are getting sold are connected TVs. So that story will become big. But for that, you still need, you know, production. You still need broadcast capabilities and stuff like that, even if you're going to go do streaming. So the mechanics of how that the eventual consumption is going to be will differ. But I don't think television is dying in India anytime soon. I think it's still the television the way it is. It'll probably be there for the next 10 years. There's no doubt about it. And digital, naturally, the whole world knows. Investments that come into India on digital, whether it's only on, I mean, if you just look at Jio during the pandemic, the kind of money that it raised to all the marquee investors, including Google, Facebook, and blah, 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 is largely because that's one medium which is penetrated across India at over 95%, right? The speeds at which people consume today. And I know most people in the audience will also would have seen if they have any people come, I mean, if they have, maids coming home and working, look at the way how they operate WhatsApp, or look at the way how they consume content, right? They know how to operate a YouTube. The kind of forwards that happen typically as videos today, I don't know the number because we don't have the number, but there is unofficial reports that, you know, maximum Q2 and tier 2 and tier 3 markets happen on video through WhatsApp. And I don't think that would be wrong, because, you know, anything that you share, typically, whether it's a link which is embedded as a YouTube link on a WhatsApp platform or any chat platform for the matter. So chat is actually becoming a source of great source of content consumption for a lot of people in India. And the moment that opportunity comes up for monetization, which I don't know whether it will or it will not, but definitely there is a huge amount of opportunity on digital. Look at how share chat is being used. Look at how voice services are getting used, whether it's Amazon, Echo, or any of those product lines that they're launching. Why would Amazon have a devices division? They clearly know, right? The market growth is going to come from a particular sector, particular sect of people who probably may not be able to even type or even read, but they know how to use voice as commands. And that works, you know, it's as long as the technology is capable of delivering seamless experiences, there's no reason. So voice commerce, for example, is going to be massive. You know, if you get into tier 2, tier 3 towns, people are ordering stuff through Eco.
Right.
So it's bizarre, but
I totally agree with you. In fact, the way me being an industry professional myself, I remember we used to run behind all the Times of India and the HTs of the world trying to get us to put an ad there. And now it's all, you know, going behind these online publishing platforms just to get a banner ad put up there. It's quite a different ballgame altogether.
I don't think, irrelevant banner ads don't work anymore. So
absolutely,
there's so many targeting capabilities that exist that can get delivered through programmatic capabilities that are on.
Yes.
It's just a matter of time that, and the matter of time is not like how it used to be 10 years ago when people said it's a matter of time. The current tsunami is going to be so fast that if marketers and strategists can't adapt themselves to the changing world, they'll be left behind. So it's good to, and this is something that we've heard for 10 years because it's not happened. But like I said, that tsunami is going to be sudden. So you'll probably have that, all the 10-year ka josh ek saath. not really them.
Right, right, right. Actually, a very interesting way you said, marketers have to adapt. So that brings me to my next question, Ram. Like, how do you think, based on your experiences, you've seen the brand side of things, you've seen the media side of things. So how do you think, or how does the brand today influence the audience through media? Like, what are the ways they can do that, and how they can be successful?
How else does it happen? I mean, see, what is media? Right? Media is a distribution capability of an idea.
Right.
You might have the most brilliant ideas, you might shoot the most brilliant commercials. How do you circulate them? How do you distribute them? So media is extremely important. And that's where the most money get spent. When I say most money, out of the small market that you have, which is about 6, 7 billion, $8 billion in overall media, right? So marketers are very skewed towards a medium that they've learned over the last 15, 20 years, right? Because the maximum buck is on the table there. The moment that shift, which is now significant and moving, like 60% of brand spends are moving to digital. But I also strongly believe that the game is not about money moving from a medium to another. Game is about the growth of the country. The growth of the country depends on how your economic situations are. Who actually would have believed 6 months ago when the second wave hit us that we would actually be in a situation that we are currently in? It's actually a phenomenal situation that we are currently in. Look at the kind of FDIs going into the country. Look at the kind of IPOs that are going up, whether it's the Indian unicorns or the large ones like Adanis of the world who are looking at IPO releases. So the market is ripe, and IPOs don't happen unless until consumers have money to buy those shares. So there's enough and more money there, not because of anything else, because jobs are again getting created. The more jobs that get created, automatically it'll reflect on how a consumer behavior is, whether it's shopping or whether it's purchasing of shares, right?
Right.
So the story is phenomenal for India, and it's just going to grow. I just believe, I've always believed, and I continue to believe that the kind of robust story that India will probably land up having, we'll all be surprised with what our prime minister says, but on becoming a $5 trillion economy. But
Yes.
it's got all the ingredients to get there. You might probably
Yeah.
not become five, you'll probably become 3.5, 4 or 4.5, whatever that number is. We already are at 3, so right. So there's no reason why all of those good things need to happen. To coming back to your question, automatically, media plays an important role. I mean, why do you think that there are so many news channels trying to propagate whatever they need to propagate? That's
Right,
all communication, right? Why do you think you got so many ads happening on an IPL? Why do you think there are still so many new cinema channels that people spend money on? The kind of GRP numbers that one can get on any of the cinema channels that exist in India is
right.
astronomical, right? The whole of US probably will not have that kind of problem because the population is less. So all of this comes back to that growth opportunity that exists with the kind of
Right.
people power that we have, which probably China had and realized in the 80s. Not that I want to compare China, it's not a country that I want to compare us with, but at least few scenarios of where those were and where we are, and our growth will be 5x faster than theirs because now the infrastructure is ready, the audiences are adapting to the new ways of doing things. All
Right.
of I mean, whether it was adapting to the technologies that were serving products that we needed to adopt, which is so many apps helping us doing whatever we need to, whether it's buying clothes or buying groceries or buying or ordering food, right? All of it is changing the way we as consumers are behaving.
Right.
And 90, I mean, look at how Paytm's growth is, right? How many of us, I don't know how many people are
Yes,
there,
that's phenomenal.
all of those people who are there online will have a Paytm, right? It's as simple as that. So, and we're not changing. We're actually changing and adapting ourselves to various scenarios that are being thrown at us. And that adaptability happens when you're open in mind. And you can only be open in mind when you're younger. It's very difficult to change behavioral aspects of human beings as they grow old. So India being such a young country, right?
I agree to that. Thanks a
All
lot.
of this is coming.
Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, okay, all right. I think I lost you for there for a minute. All right.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Thank you so much for that. In fact, like you said, media has been the primary way of dispersing and taking all the messages to the masses, right? And they have been influencing the media, influencing the masses all through. But we are talking about shaping brands here. So the I would probably
so from brand, a market when you distribute, brands get shaped with the kind of top of mind that people register. Brands register with people, right?
Yeah.
I gave you a prelude, which just meant that media plays a very, very important role in shaping brands. That's what I'm
yes,
trying.
Yes, yes, absolutely, absolutely. So not what I'm trying to get at is
important thing to. I mean, all your communication is good, like I said, right? You might have the most brilliant idea. If I don't see your idea,
there's no point in doing it. Actually,
so then you now decide. Now you decide whether media is important or not, or and how it can shape. Whether there are different genres involved, where you need to advertise. There's so many genres that are available, right? So point, bottom line, media plays the most important role in shaping brands, comma, period, exclamation.
So that's it. Like, all in all, media is the king. It'll take you everywhere, right? So, okay. So coming from you, since you work with so many brands, given today's scenario, what would be the top five media channels you would suggest for brands to actually focus on? So if you have to,
depends.
I know there are a lot.
So see, you suddenly if I just come and say, oh, tomorrow you become digital. If I don't have KB, even if I don't have a basic website,
right?
There's a brand called Kolu Bale, right? Taylor.
Okay.
My Kolu Bale and they're the largest spenders in media in Gujarat and Maharashtra, right? Kolu Bale and Bell Kolu. So Kolu Bale is what we call, but it's called Bell Kolu. The brand name is Bell Kolu. You can Google it up. Now, if I usko jaake bolu to abhi digitally kahani shuru kar de raha, transformation kar and ye kar and wo kar. So it depends on whom you're talking to and how progressive the brand has been, right? In terms of adopting to mediums. So there's I cannot just pinpoint and say what are the questions that were like five different
top five media channels that a brand should, or you can probably give us industry.
Each category is different. See, if you look at the most, let's take finance as a category. That's the most progressive. Naturally, digital channels mean a lot.
Yes.
Right? So naturally, there it will be digital first. To ensure that digital happens, you have television, which supports that. Whenever television is on, search numbers have always increased for brands. That's a direct correlation to how television impacts search capabilities in India and generates new audiences, new customers, and that. And then you have the social platforms that exist, and then various retargeting capabilities back, bringing back technology into play, which will have AI, ML, and all of that shit that happens. But that pyramid will change when more and more customer acquisition happens. Why do you think that Amazon is advertising on television? Why do you think that Flipkart and Myntras are burning billions of, because you got the top 100 million people who are transacting, but there are 1.3 billion people, of which 350 million still watch cable and satellite.
Yeah.
And if they watch cable and satellite, they got the capability to go online and purchase or do voice commerce. So there's all kinds of stuff that exists. So it finance as a category will follow that path, whereas Amazon will probably be, in India television first, right? And digital will be equivalent to television spends. So you don't want to be off radar naturally. But Amazon as a platform itself is, in the US, the biggest threat for Google is Amazon, because the searches that are happening are not happening on Google, on products and not on services, but mostly on products and e-commerce is so big. So the biggest threat for Google in the US in terms of right from data to the kind of data that Amazon has, it can be Google hollow, right? So that's the truth of life. So if somebody asks me which is the biggest search platform in the world today, it is Amazon.
Okay, that's a very interesting take.
It is. I mean, not for all categories, but it still is as large as Google on search.
I think for shopping, I think Amazon trumps, because even though Google has its own merchant store, the kind of experience you get in Amazon while you're searching for something, it's quite different. Plus the, of course, there are a lot of offers and all which really entice, but I would second that. In fact, that's a very good way of putting it, because not everybody thinks that way. We always, for search, it's Google. I think when we subconsciously, when we want to search a product, we'll go for Amazon, we'll not go and search on Google. So I think that's a very good point put forth, and I think most of our audience will also relate to that. So thanks a lot, Ram, for that. Right, so I kind of got your answer. So basically, the gist of it would be understand your category, understand where your audience are, and try to, you know, use the appropriate medium to reach out to them. If I can summarize that. Yeah. All right. Thank you so much. So moving on, Ram, you did mention social channels. So do you think social media has come to the forefront over the last few years, and how
it
has
it
impact?
It has.
I mean,
you know, depending on what you believe, and how your belief translates into actions, right? Okay. Now, if you ask me, and I've always been saying that, in a young country like India, brands lie in the hands of the consumer. That's the truth of life today. Brands can make, break brands. Consumers can make, break brands.
Can make brands, yeah. Got it.
And if you look at the kind of, which are the categories that actually understood this very well early on, it was telecom as a category, banks, BFSI as a category, because the kind of chatter that happens determines how your service levels are going to be.
Right.
And service levels play a very, very important role in today's world on customer satisfaction, right? Mm. And customer satisfaction yields a lot many more things on advocacy, which leads to, conversions.
Right.
So advocacy is a very, 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 very powerful methodology which was not captured earlier. People knew word of mouth. Which is now has a sophisticated terminology called advocacy, because it's no more just word of mouth. There are different channels through which you communicate, because that's right. What social helps in, right? If I like something, I want to talk about it. I want to share that information. If I want to do a redressal, I would want to do that on Twitter, because I know that the millions of people who are watching it, brands don't want to be ashamed before their own consumers, right? So they immediately act on it. So when the brand is in, when and the categories which believe that brands is in the hands, I mean, consumer, what am I saying? Consumers, I mean, brands are in the hands of the consumer.
Yeah.
Those brands work very differently, right? They very clearly know what needs to get done and how it needs to get done. And we've seen a lot of these success stories around that, right? So social is extremely critical, because brands get built from listening to what consumers are saying.
That's a very interesting point. Yeah,
it is. I mean, that's the truth. The kind of ORM practices that we have in the country, and what we do at DDB, some of the largest brands work with us on ORM, right? And listening, not just reputation management, I'm saying response management as well.
Yes.
ORM is more online reputation management. ORM is now more, and response has mechanisms which controls reputation, which controls brand building image, and also client delight. So response becomes a lot more powerful word in ORM, in the ORM world, than reputation, because reputation is just one thing. How do I manage myself before people? Whereas you don't build brands by managing yourself before people. You build brands by listening to what people say, and therefore responding to what people are saying to in a manner that is going to be of right from being empathetic all the way to pompous, different emotions that you touch, and that makes a lot of difference.
Right. So, I mean, I'm very happy that you spoke about listening and ORM and reputation. I mean, response management, because coincidentally, I mean, Connect Insights is technology that basically. Right, and I'm very happy to hear that, and I would like to probe more on that. But first, coming to our topic, that is the evolution of media. So, going forward, right now, from now, say the next 10 years, how do you see the landscape evolving for the media? Any thoughts on that?
So, television is going to be there. Digital will equal television. There'll be a lot more audiences. There'll be a lot more spends. India's story is powerful economically. Like I said, when we grow, there'll be a lot more new consumers will be onboarded. And once new consumers get onboarded, naturally, there will be a lot more, brands who want to target those consumers so that they can experience their products and services. So next 10 years is going to be pretty crazy. I think as we get after 10 years, we'll probably be half of where the US is in terms of.
Okay.
The size, still, because there's still so much more potential. You got to you got to 100 million e-commerce transactions in 10 years. You'll probably get to 300 million, but our population is 1.3 million, 1.3 billion.
Billion, yeah.
US population is just 350 million.
Yes. Right?
So the more people you have, the pricing pressure of it being lower will be higher in India on the media side of it. Hmm. Unlike the US, where it will always keep climbing because they are in a different zone in terms of number of people and population and stuff like that.
Right. For everybody, that's a good learning that where we are going to stand and how media is going to evolve in the next 10 years. And digital and television is what Ram feels is going to be big. And I'm sure everybody in India will agree to that. And I'm sure brands will also be able to, you know, focus on these channels. So when you're talking about focusing, I would like to come back to a topic which is dear to me, that is listening. So do you think social listening will influence the evolution of media, influence the way consumers, consumed information from media, and therefore the evolution of the way, you know, channels and the way different, you know, aspects of media develop over the course of the years?
So it's actually a tough one to answer, but I'm going to attempt answering it. Mm-hmm. See, I don't think that it will influence evolution of media.
Okay.
But it will influence brand decisions.
Okay.
So that's two different things altogether. Right?
Yeah.
So when I say how will it influence brands' decision in terms of building up a strategy, because the moment you start listening to what your consumers are saying, mm-hmm. your communication to that will change. Right? Because now, let's say Axe, for example, as a brand, all this while was showing off, by saying that aap axe lagao aur ladkiyan hoon hoon karegi. That might not be the case 2 years hence. That's been running for the last 10 years. 10 years ago, guys would want to have felt like that.
Hmm.
I don't think guys think like that anymore. Or, I mean, I never thought that they thought like that, but when I see all these sprays, body sprays, talking the same language, somewhere there is something which has come out in research which says that, oh, this kind of communication actually enthralls men. Right. And it's very close to sexual.
So
that story will evolve. I'm just giving you an example, right?
Yeah.
And it could be Axe, it could be any brand which is in that so when they start listening to what their consumers are saying, which is happening, but not at the pace where brand strategies would change, right? But it's a very, very important aspect. Mm-hmm. It will influence, and we're seeing that, right? Look at our classic cases. Because what it does, it builds a lot more affinity. Mm-hmm. When you build affinity, the chances of conversion is high,
right?
We did something for Spotify. The 22 feet team was listening, and somebody who saw a biscuit, mm-hmm. A good day biscuit. My father, me, would ideally, when we saw the biscuit, we would have seen it as a good day biscuit.
Right.
But that guy who tweeted was a 19 or 20 year old guy. His first brand recall was Spotify.
Hmm.
Right. I don't know how many of you all have seen the Spotify logo change for about over a week, which won several awards as well. They changed their logo and put the Good Day Biscuit because it had the Spotify logo. You remember? Do you know how the Good Day Biscuit looks?
Yeah, I do. We have one now. Right.
So, you know, that's how powerful listening can be, because imagine that guy has not had his first thing is he's been listening to music. He's the young gun of the country. He's got
right.
a Spotify on his phone. The first thing he looks at that biscuit and says Spotify, right? And when that listening happened, brand changed its logo. That's a powerful initiative. They were very bold and powerful, progressive rather than powerful. And, that's the kind of brand decisions that people take, that they can put up a biscuit on their logo. Not many people will be as progressive as doing that, but that's a great start, right? Look at how we're changing consumer behavior for income tax department.
Yes.
We handle that, right? And you're partners with us on that.
Right.
See, it's a government brand, so you can't be too funky about how you communicate. So your communication will be apt, it will be straight to the point, and it is very much friendlier. Earlier, the first thing that we used to think about income tax, for example, the perception is that everybody used to be scared of even going to income tax. So right. they used to feel threatened. Mm-hmm. It's not the case now. There's a huge behavioral change that has happened. How does that happen? Right. Because you now become a lot more friendlier because of the available social channels that exist. And income tax as a department is not seen as a fearful monster sitting out there to screw you. It's more friendlier. The kind of return, if the kind of, you know, refunds that you're getting or the kind of number of people who are paying taxes, all of it has increased. And that happens only when you're a lot more friendlier. And look at the kind of tweets that are happening around income tax. While there was an issue when their portal was not functioning because of technological reasons, it's flawless now, right? But that's behavioral change at the consumer end. Now, that's not a brand, but still is the largest brand in the country because it addresses so many million people as their own, right? There are so many people who are paying taxes in the country.
Right.
Now, if you look at addressable audience, on the brand side of it, income tax department probably be the biggest in terms of how they handle social media listening and how they respond to responses and stuff like that. So we do that. We take big pride in doing that. And I think it's one of those big case studies which we believe at some stage will become very award worthy over the years.
Okay. Thank you so much, Ram. I mean, that was a very good insight coming with regards to social listening and how it will influence brands the way they use media. And I think that's a very interesting perspective there. And thanks for the ITD case study also.
I don't know whether you remember in the US, there's a brand called United, which is an airline company.
Yeah.
How many of you will have seen those? The guy in the tarmac when the flight was about to take off, he saw a small baby crying and he was dancing for her.
I think it was making the round lately on
American. It is not United. It is not United.
American.
Double A, American Airlines. So have a look at it. I mean, they the kind of, and he's an employee in Canada, if I'm not wrong. And it went. It was covered. The virality is a different story. But look at the media coverage that they got worldwide, without spending a dime. Now that's because the affinity of the worker who's working for the brand, right, enabled a disgruntled 3-year-old
right
to not cry. That is showing love for customers, right? That
right,
came
right.
from an employee. Now, who influences a brand to reach the kind of mileage that it can? You never know. It can come from a guy who is trafficking on a tarmac. You know, it's unbelievable. Also, you know, if you look at how United lost shares because, you know, there's a song called United Broke My Guitar.
The guitar incident, I remember that,
They got about close to, I think about $2-3 billion got wiped out one day. It came back.
Because they were not able to handle it properly.
You just couldn't do anything about it, right?
I remember that.
And we also know when Elon Musk smokes up and the kind of tweets that he does, SpaceX. And he brings it down, he takes it up, he brings Tesla up, he brings it down. But he doesn't care about what he's got to say and how, because for these people, right, what is of value is what they create, right? What is of value is how a consumer is going to be benefiting from what they create. They don't care about money. Money is secondary, right? At least with the American Airlines example and Elon Musk as an example, right? Because they bounced back. Today he's the largest car manufacturer. 6 months ago his shares had tumbled. Right? So that's the way it is.
Absolutely. So I think, Ram, what has happened is I think we've just overshot the time, but no worries. So what I'll do is I'll take one question from the audience. So very interesting question here. So, you know, we've spoken about a lot about how we use media to disseminate information, right? But considering that today it's all about, you know, customer service and customer experience, how does media play a role in the customer experience or a customer service bit of it? So your take on that.
So when I say, okay, let's go back into what I said. Media is a platform where messages get distributed. Whether you do by paying for it or whether it goes from a consumer who is actually holding a brand at stake,
right,
it doesn't matter. Right. So Naturally, media plays a big role. So if I had to, the social media, for example, is the largest platform through which you would probably be able to communicate whatever you want to with a brand, which never happened 10 years ago.
Right.
So media does influence a lot, and answers your question as well. I think if I have not, then we can elaborate on it a little bit more.
Sure. So, I mean, so just digging further, so, I mean, would you say social media could be one of those channels where it's that two-way interaction enables, you know, brands
to come with
customers?
Absolutely. You can't do that on television.
Yeah, you can't do that on television.
Right. You can probably, when Cadbury's screw-up happened about 10 years ago, Amitabh Bachchan had to go, I mean, worms came out of Cadbury's. I mean, that became a disaster for the brand. But look at how they had to handle it then. Hmm. They wouldn't do that if something like that ever happens. God forbid it doesn't. But if it does, anything major happens in like how it did, because they had to bring Amitabh Bachchan on television, and he had to go show how the factory is, how clean the whole process is and stuff like that. But imagine if something like that happens today, it won't happen on television. It's responded like that on
social media, social platform, right?
Yeah.
All right. I think we should take a wrap now because it's already 5 minutes above our schedule time. Again, thank you very much, Ram. The session was very, very insightful. It's especially about the journey and how media is the king of. If you say content is king, then probably media is probably a bit bigger role because it takes that content to the masses. So thank you very much for that and all the questions that we've answered. If for the audience, if you have any questions, you can reach out to us, and we will be able to take this forward to Ram. And
I see a couple of questions. I'll answer one. There is Siley, yeah, who said how media planning is different from media strategy. Media planning is platform driven, where you're dependent on data, which translates your plans as per brand objectives and markets, keeping in mind how you need to build a plan, because it's very, very centric to platforms. Media strategy is way too different. I mean, media planning is dependent on budgets as well. Media strategy need not be on budgets. Media strategy is something that you do as a strategy extension to the brand planning story that you do, which will showcase what all you can do and how you can do it, right? It does not say that this is what you need to do. Whereas planning says this is what you need to do because you're bound with budgets, you're bound with markets, you're bound with channels that you need to use. So it's very different. All the ideation aspects of it falls under media strategy, along with what I just said. But eventually, paisa bolta hai.
It's all about money after all. That is true. All right. Okay. Anything else? So we can then close the session. Okay.
Sounds good. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it. And thank you everybody for joining us. All those who have registered will also get a recording of this. So if you've not been able to sit through the whole session, you'll get this recording, so you'll not miss out on anything. And thank you, everybody. We'll have come back with the next webinar. Thank you, Ram, so much for all your time and giving us those wonderful tidbits about media and the evolutions. Appreciate it. Take care. Have a nice weekend ahead. Bye-bye.
Happy Diwali to everybody.